This is the story of something that happened to me, or something I did. I'm not sure which. I'm not sure which is worse. When I came back to Bristol, Martin's letter was waiting. The envelope was fat. He'd gone over the address twice. I knew without opening it the effort he'd made. I didn't open it for 2 days.
Dear Clare, I don't know if this will reach you. I don't know if you'll read it if it does. It's been a year since I saw you. I want to give an account of what happened. I've said sorry, but the more time passes, the clearer I am about what I'm sorry for. I have to go back to the start, my last day fixing your roof. It was boiling. You've been passing me cold drinks through the window for days. I've been climbing in and out of your flat to use your toilet. I wanted to ask you out, but I couldn't do it. Then, on that last day, you climbed out to see the new tiles and you sat next to me on the parapet and stared at the view. And then you turned back to me and...
We kissed.
We kissed. I didn't know.
You must have.
No.
I kept bringing you drinks.
But you're a nice person. And it's hot. You'd have done it for anyone.
Not ice and straws.
You'd never pop your head out last summer. Rain non-stop.
I didn't live here.
I wasn't free. And then you said, meant to be. When we got married, everyone said, what's the hurry? And we said, that's the wrong question. The right question is, why delay? We didn't get married too quickly.
We did. Everything could have been avoided if we'd taken more time.
Meant to be was right. Us meeting, us falling in love, the wedding. I didn't just fall for you. It was all of you. I remember when it happened. That day at Justine's.
Okay, well, thank you all for coming. This is a big day for me. I realised a few months ago that the reason that I wasn't a totally together person was because I didn't have a utility room. Now I have, and I will be.
Yeah, right.
Never.
Yes, the ever-present support of my sons. It inhibits me sometimes being put on this pedestal. Carl, this item is a laundry basket.
Nice.
Owen, this is called detergent that I bear no grudges, not even towards Mick, who calls it my futility room because he paid for it.
Through the nose.
Well, I am grateful, dear. So, Mum, could you pass the scissors, please?
This bacon rind stuck on them, Justine.
That's the kind of thing that won't happen, thank you, from now on. So, let's raise our glasses and snip the ribbon and officially open the utility room.
And we all crammed in that little extension. You and me, your mum, Owen and Carl and Nicky poking about, looking at sockets and the new window. And I hadn't eaten anything and I whispered to you that I was starving and you turned to Nicky and said...
Is she going to feed us?
Oh, I don't know.
Mum, is she going to feed us?
Mum, is Justine going to feed us?
I don't know, Nicky.
Justine?
Yes?
Are you going to feed us?
Am I meant to? Martin, are you hungry?
Look at him. He's starving.
Shit. Okay, I'll look in the freezer. I'm going to look in the freezer right now.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. Was that rude?
Don't be silly, Martin.
Oh, we're all starving.
And I thought, if this happened in my family... Well, none of it would happen in my family, but if it did, nobody would say anything. Anyway, we all made that meal. Everyone got given something to chop or peel. I was floundering around trying to lay the table, and what I noticed was how often I was touched. A hand on my shoulder, a friendly shove if I was in the way. And I realised that you all touched each other all the time. And I was included, and I thought, I'm in love with this family.
Well, I remember the day too, and there were warning signs. We just chose not to see them.
So, Martin... What's the most surprising thing you've discovered about my sister Clare? That is fit for public consumption.
Oh. She picks up other people's rubbish. We were on a walk and someone had left their old picnic in a carrier bag, and Clare carried it all round our walk and back to the car park and binned it. And I said she was a model citizen. And she said,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.